Welcome back to Jazz Alive as we move from the Montreux Jazz Festival to the campus of Ohio State University in February of 1977 to hear Don Ellis with the Ohio State University Jazz Ensemble. For the introduction, we go to the stage of the Mershon Auditorium and OSU Ensemble Director Tom Battenberg.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are about to experience the man of whom it has been written, he can do anything. And he has done nearly everything, from appearances with big bands such as Charlie Barnett, Lionel Hampton, Woody Herman, Stan Kenton, and Maynard Ferguson, to symphonies like the Los Angeles Philharmonic under Zubin Mehta, to the New York Philharmonic under Leonard Bernstein. You have heard him on records with Charlie Mingus, George Russell, Maynard Ferguson, Michelle Legrand, the New York Philharmonic, Frank Zappa, and 14 albums of his own. You have heard his music on TV commercials for Arco, Cougar, and Toyota. You have experienced his music on the NBC series Doctor's Hospital and in movies like 7-Ups, Kansas City Bomber, French Connection, and French Connection 2. And now, here he is, in person to do anything and everything, the exciting Mr. French Connection himself, Don Ellis.
Kid, and I didn't know I was going to be a musician or anything like that. I was just, you know, about in the second or third grade. No, second grade, I think it was. My father took me to hear a concert band play, and I remember they did 76 trombones or something like that, and all the trombone players got down and stretched out the whole length of the stage and were doing this thing with the slide. And I was really impressed. I thought that just looked great, going in and out and stuff. And so I always wanted to play the trombone. So I asked Santa Claus for a trombone for Christmas, but I didn't spell too good at that age. And what I got was a trumpet instead of a trombone. But it was shiny and nice, and so it was just as good as a trombone. But a little over a year ago, I decided that, some of you know, I was ill and I'd been out of commission for a while. And I was getting back and I thought, well, what's maybe an easier instrument? I was schooled there, right? But what's an easier instrument to play than the trumpet? And so I thought, my old friend the trombone. So I got a trombone, which is not an ordinary trombone. It's a super bone, thus making myself a super boner. Anyway, a super bone is an animal instrument which allows you, it's the same as a trombone, it's the same as a valve trombone, and it's the same as the slide trombone, only it goes both ways at the same time. So I can either go up and down or in and out, whichever I choose, and I can do it both at once. And of course, if you've seen Maynard Ferguson, Maynard and a guy at Holton Company were responsible for developing it, and it's great for somebody who, like myself, always wanted to play trombone but never dared ask how. And really never developed any slide technique. I never played it before last year. And so when I get hung up, I use the valves, and then for certain things I use the slide, and it works very nicely. And in any case, I wrote a composition which I think is very nice. And in case I don't sound too good, the composition will make up for it, because the band sounds beautiful on it. And it's called Palomar. We're gonna take you through a lot of different moods and emotions now. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
This is another kind of trumpet. And this particular trumpet is a quarter tone trumpet. And the reason it's a quarter tone trumpet is because I say so. I invented it and I can call it anything I want. And the reason it is because it has, as you notice, four valves instead of the normal two. This enables me to play in the cracks of the piano. Now, the smallest note, the smallest interval that most people are familiar with is a half step, which is the smallest thing you can play on a piano. However, I can do one better. I can play in between the cracks by using my fourth pinky here, digit, or whatever it's called, and I can play in the cracks of the piano. And this creates unusual effects and some consternation with people who have perfect pitch. Nevertheless, normal trumpet players can only play 12 notes of the octave, and I can play 24, so not necessarily makes me better, but it certainly gives me more to do. So what I'd like to do for this one, we're going to do a number simply called the blues, because I think every jazz program should have a number that's the blues. It doesn't have to be called the blues, but there should be a blues on it somewhere. And so this is my blues, and I'm going to use the quarter tone valve. Ha ha! very much. And now, we'd like to do, I guess, what I'm most famous or infamous for. We were playing, my band and I were playing in New York at Lincoln Center, and a guy came up to me, two guys came up to me, one was Billy Friedkin, the other was Phil Vantoni, and they said, "That's the sound we want for our movie, and you're going to do it." And I said, sure, because everybody does that, you know, like the Hollywood types. Everybody says they want you to do their movie, and no one ever does. But these guys came through, and it turned out to be the hottest movie of that year, and just about any year. And then there was a sequel to it. And what we'd like to do now is do a medley from The French Connection. We're going to start with French Connection 2 and then segue into French Connection 1, featuring a number of the people in the band as we go along. And they're very nervous about this, I have to tell you, because I told them that, like, we're not going to follow the music exactly. We're going to change it around a little bit. The thing is, you see, I couldn't tell them how we were going to do it because I don't know yet. I haven't figured it out. And I won't know until we get there. But, you know, if all else fails, we just have a drum solo. They won't know the difference. French Connection. We'll be right back.
Don Ellis with the Ohio State University Jazz Ensemble under the direction of Tom Battenberg. This set with Don Ellis and the OSU Ensemble was recorded on location in Columbus, Ohio, by Ed Thompson, Larry Reynolds, Dave Lucas, and Quick Coddington. It was produced for Jazz Alive by John Archer at WOSU.